Hi, my name is Raymond Baziwane. I'm a program manager on the AKS on Azure Stack HCI team at Microsoft. In this demo, I'll be showing you how to deploy Azure SQL Managed Instance on AKS HCI. Before you begin, verify that you have the following: a Kubernetes cluster with Linux-only worker nodes. In my case, I'm using AKS HCI. Make sure you have configured your local kubectl environment to point to your Kubernetes cluster. And lastly, the latest AZ Data CLI installed in your local environment. In case you're wondering what Azure SQL Managed Instance really means, here's a good visual representation of the Azure Arc-enabled data services architecture we're going to be deploying in this demo. Starting at the bottom is the infrastructure layer, and this could be any infrastructure that you currently have in your environment. For example, Windows Server 2019 data center with Hyper-V, or Azure Stack HCI, or VMware, name it. So on this infrastructure, you then deploy a Kubernetes distribution like AKS or AKS HCI, OpenShift, VMware Tanzu, etc. We have multiple Kubernetes distros listed here because Arc Data Services runs on any Kubernetes. Then on Kubernetes, you then deploy what we call the Azure Arc Data Controller. This controller has integration with Azure Arc that allows it to exchange information with Azure, right here. Some data such as billing, telemetry will be sent up to Azure, and some information will flow down, which includes RBAC and policy, inventory, identity, etc., as you can see in this illustration. The data controller then helps you create Azure SQL Managed Instances, which kind of sit right here in the architecture. So given this, how does one actually deploy Azure SQL Managed Instances? First is to deploy the Azure Arc Data Controller. You can do it using Azure Data Studio or AZ Data CLI, which uses the Kubernetes API to pull down the container images needed to stand up the Azure Arc Data Controller. The Data Controller is simply a set of container images that are provisioned on Kubernetes and provide all the management services mentioned right here, such as monitoring, backup, etc. Once the data controller is in place, the different instances can be provisioned, such as SQL Managed Instance or Postgres Hyperscale. To install the Arc Data Controller on AKS HCI, I have this single AZ Data CLI command I have saved in a PowerShell script that uses the AKS HCI profile configuration. And it takes in a series of arguments, which include the Azure subscription, resource group, and location in which I want to create my instances. It also takes the cluster namespace and controller name. This is simply the name or title of the namespace that is created in Kubernetes. Note that controller pods and eventually your SQL Server instances will all reside in whatever namespace you specify in these settings. But before I run this, let's take a look at my Kubernetes cluster. For this, I'll quickly switch to my command line and run kubectl get nodes. As you can tell, I'm running a two-node cluster on this machine. We do not recommend two-node cluster deployments for production workloads. This particular cluster is set up for lightweight testing and definitely not built for any kind of production applications. As you can see, my cluster is a Linux-only nodes. We are using Mariner Linux-based images for Linux worker nodes. Mariner is Microsoft's open source Linux distro, in case you are wondering. Next, let's check the list of namespaces that we have on the cluster. Awesome. So this is a list of namespaces that I have on this cluster. This is important, as you'll see later, what happens behind the scenes post deployment of the Arc controller and SQL managed instance. To kick off the Arc data controller installation, I'll switch back quickly to Visual Studio Code and run my script. It will take a minute. We'll enter username password here. It took less than 5 minutes. At the end of the deployment, you should have an endpoint to your Arc data controller listed there. With the Azure Arc data controller now deployed, we are now ready to start creating SQL managed instances on our clusters. Creating Azure SQL Managed Instance is quite easy using Azure Data Studio or the AZ Data CLI. As you can see, I have another single AZ Data CLI command that simply takes the name of the instance and the number of replicas that I want to create. In my case, 3. Before I run the script, I need to log into my data controller. So I'll run AZ data login. Just expand this a little. Okay. Namespace I had forgotten. It was contosto. Okay, so it shows that I'm successfully logged in to my data controller. Now I'll simply run my script. You will be prompted to provide details for your SQL Server instance. I'll just skip over to the end. Once the instance creation is completed, you should see a ready message. So the next thing I'll do is I'll take this endpoint and use Azure Data Studio to see what was created. I've gone ahead in Azure Data Studio and logged into my Arc Data Controller. As you can see, I have a healthy SQL managed instance deployed on AKS HCI. In Azure Data Studio, you will also notice that there are endpoints to both Kibana and Grafana in case you want to monitor your instances. Lastly, let's switch back to our command line and take a look at what happened behind the scenes in Kubernetes. First, I'll run kubectl get namespaces. Notice that behind the scenes, the deployment actually created a namespace, Contoso development. Let me dig in a bit in what is in this namespace so that we can take a look. Space. Let's try that again. All right. You will see all the Kubernetes resources that were created as part of this deployment. And let's quickly take a look at the persistent volumes. Type. There we go. So these are the list of persistent volumes that our pods are already claiming. This is data, so we would expect some persistent layer resources to be consumed in Kubernetes. Well, that concludes our demo. Hopefully I have given you some ideas on how you can use Azure SQL Managed Instance in your stateful application development. In case you want to learn more, here's a list of resources.